Hey, Jason.
How you doing?
Ned. Hey, how's it going?
I'm doing well. What are you doing here?
Actually, I just had to replace some lecture notes, and Miguel bailed me out. Have you guys met?
No, not formally.
Ned Ashton, Miguel Morris.
Oh,
Ned Ashton.
Miguel, are you the singer everyone's been talking about?
I am just a bartender. I'm not a singer.
Hello, Ned.
Wow.
I'm happy to see you, too. Jason, hi. I haven't seen you in a long time. You breaking away from the book?
No, believe it or not, I'm here on an urgent academic mission.
Ooh, don't work too hard. Excuse me. Can I get a bottle of champagne? Something cold, smooth, and very, very dry.
Sure. Absolutely.
Thank you.
What do you think about this?
Perfect.
Miguel, I know you work here as a bartender, but didn't you sing here one night?
Yeah.
Yes. And Brenda is still raving about it. She told me the band's manager said that he was incredibly talented. So did grandmother. But the real kicker is, grandfather was impressed.
So are you planning on making a career out of this? You know, bright lights, glitz, glamour, rock and roll?
No way, no way. It was just a favor from Mark and Felicia. The band's lead singer never showed up. What a jerk. Excuse me.
Hey, I gotta hit these notes. You guys have fun.
Don't worry, we will.
Hey, Miguel, thanks again. Remember, I owe you one.
Hey, come on, I was happy to help. I know what it is to lose one of those.
Yeah, yeah, your life starts flashing before your eyes and you really panic.
That's right. Take care, man.
Thanks.
Good luck. See you later.
All right.
Thank you. Are you ready for an incredible evening?
Well, let's see. Sensitive as I am to nuance, I'd have to say the tone, the apparel, the setting all lends itself to something spectacular. I can't wait to hear what you have in mind.
Well, there's absolutely no rush. And in the immortal words of Margaret Hamilton, these things need to be handled delicately.
Ooh, a witch's spell. I'm intrigued.
Good. And be assured that you are going to remember this night for a very long time.
Thank you, Miguel.
If you need anything else, just let me know.
We will. I would like to propose a toast. A mutual celebration and partnership.
Cheers.
I have a business proposition for you, Mr. Ashton.
Oh. Well, I'm delighted, Miss Bell. So far, business with you has been all pleasure. Let's hear your pitch.
No, not yet. Like I said, this is worth waiting for. And I want to build to the big moment. So why don't we just relax and contemplate the possibilities?
I already am.
We're really good together. You know that, don't you?
I won't argue with that. We've done pretty well.
I mean, the list of accomplishments are amazing. We've managed Edward. We've had some incredible PR crews. And the best part, at least for me, is acquiring deception.
And infuriate Lucy.
Well, that's just a side benefit. I think it's a huge asset for ELQ.
No arguments here. Did I thank you properly for letting Edward think that was my idea?
Yes, you did. But I am insatiable when it comes to gratitude.
Mm-hmm. You're insatiable in a number of areas.
Is that a complaint?
No. Absolutely not.
You know, I think in the future we are going to look back at this purchase of deception as the beginning of a very profitable relationship. There really is no limit.
I wholeheartedly agree. And so does my bank account.
Well, I want you both to be happy. And I know that that's important to you. It must be difficult having non-business people in the firm. I mean, hard for them to see the big picture.
Yeah, well, it's a family shop, and that's just the way it is. Unfortunately for Grandfather,
His business instincts didn't breed true in the next generation.
Alan.
Perfect example. He's a great doctor. He's got very good common sense. But he doesn't have the faintest understanding of macroeconomics. I don't think he even bothers to balance his checkbook.
Well, it must be difficult for you to get your ideas across to him.
Mm-hmm. Sometimes I wonder if his sole mission in life is to mess me up.
Well, that's a tad paranoid, isn't it?
No, not at all. A couple of times, Alan has tried to step forward and take a more active role in ELQ. And every single time, things turned out worse than when he started. I don't think he's made a decent investment in his life. I don't think he has the faintest idea where to find one.
Well, we can't all be captains of industry.
Grandfather wanted us. No. In fact, he expected us to be just that. My mother, Tracy, was the only one of the children with really any business sense. But the problem with her was every time she got emotionally involved, those business instincts just sort of flew out the window in the wake of a love affair or a temper tantrum.
You know, I'd really like to know your mother.
You might want to rethink that.
Well, is she really that formidable?
In a word, yes.
So, all the cues are interesting. But I suppose that Alan is the most admired in Port Charles, all right?
Well, the aura of medicine and all that.
Well, is he really such a sterling character?
There's more than one skeleton rattling in that closet. So many, in fact, you can't close the door. Jason, for example. It's kind of hard to keep a child from an extramarital affair under wraps.
I suspected as much. You know, I really could help you as far as Alan's concerned.
My, my, my. Aren't you feeling omnipotent tonight? Time yet for your business proposition?
Patience, Ned. The more intense the anticipation, the more delightful the fulfillment.
How much is this going to cost me?
You are such a cynic. Far less than you think. And much more than you could possibly imagine. Let's dance.
Let's do it.